Today we're playing NCAA 06, watching something in the background,
because
I like this.
We're
fighting against South Carolina. We're going to see if we can beat them.
Taking the field for this offense is a very, very talented running back. This offense really thrives on him getting things going on the ground.
But Brent, it's not going to be easy today. He's going up against a very tough run defense.
Yeah, this defense has been watching film of his playmaking running back all week. They're up to the challenge, and if they shut him down, they can ultimately decide the outcome of this game.
That could have been caught.
Second and 10, ball on the 15-yard line. Tennessee goes with the ace set here. Back to pass, steps up, lets it go.
That's caught. He get it.
It falls incomplete. With that pressure, he just couldn't do much with it.
His chance of accuracy on that throw was practically zero. Good job, by
the way. Shut the hell up.
Down at 10 coming up. Ball on their own 15. Tennessee comes out with two tight ends. Gets the ball. No, they faked it. Looks. Jakes off a tackle.
He caught it.
Waits till the last moment.
Come on.
And he dropped it. Oh, he could have had a big reception that time. Just let that
sit down. Shut up, please.
This when the defense is in your face like that. Number 7 comes to the line with 3 wide. Play action. He steps up. He
That's
throws
quiet.
A dart to the
That's
right.
Quiet. That's quiet.
He got it. And they finally knock him out at the 17. And that reception gives him 1,500 yards for the year.
I'll tell you what, this kid's really having a big year. Not only does he have the receiving numbers, but he's helped his team win a few games along the way.
And that's what counts most. Winning football games. All those individual accolades are great, but winning is priority number one for everybody.
First and 10, ball on the 17-yard line. The volunteer set up in the gun. They'll throw on first down. He's looking. Under pressure. Looks like he's going to run. And they picked up 4 yards on the scramble. It's second down at 6 to go. Ball on the 13-yard line. The ball come out going 3 wide. Rolls right. Looks.
Lock.
No one open, so he's going to run. He's on the run. Touchdown, Tennessee. He really made that happen after the play looked completely dead.
Excellent individual effort. I must say he's showing some toughness.
That was funny. Block. Thank you. He didn't tackle me. He didn't tackle me again. He waited till I got the touchdown to tackle me. What, Fatty? What? What you hear?
Yeah.
return. And he got all of this one. Great kick.
Anybody else?
Number 8 in the end zone. So before the offense hits the field, let's take the time to let you know that our game is brought to you by EA Sports.
Who's going in? You don't win this game, I swear. One game, but that was the computer fault. With my dude got injured.
On the ground with a tailback. He's hit and got away. And he's tackled. That's a 7-yard gain.
7-yard gain on the play.
The second down and 3 to go. All on their own 27. The Gamecocks line up with 5 receivers.
Oh, come on. That was in. That could have been an interception right there, but no. He dropped it twice. Boom. Boom. See? He batted it. Could have caught it. No. He dropped it.
We get 3rd and 3 here. Ball on the 27-yard line. The Gamecocks line up in an I formation. They'll drop it for a loss. A big loss after they stuffed the run.
Not much you can say there. The defense just
they got three jerseys and we don't even have 3 jerseys.
Big set. There's a play fake. He rolls out to the left. Looking. He can scoot. Tackle. He had a whole lot of room to run on that one.
When the pressure's coming from the inside and the quarterback can escape the pocket, it usually means he's going to have some room to run.
1st and 10. Ball on the 29-yard line. Tennessee goes with the ace set here. They'll throw on 1st down. Throws it to the outside. Brought down.
Nice decision by the quarterback. Not only was it good decision making, but the offensive line protected just long enough for him to find his target.
And when you combine the two, it'll be a 1st down 9 out of 10 times.
Their last trip down here was a success. Let's see if this one will result in another touchdown. Someone got a hand on it. The ball is knocked to the ground.
Players use anything they can to get in the way of a pass.
Tennessee hasn't been very successful this season with their red zone attempts.
No, not at all. When they get inside the 20, they always seem to throw a pick, fumble the ball, or commit a penalty. Everything but put points up.
He's throwing
it. He drops back. He's looking. Rolls to the right.
Touchdown.
Wants to throw outside. He goes up and gets it. It's a touchdown. Great connection between the quarterback and receiver to put up 6 points.
These two have an unspoken communication that comes from
the way he jumped up and got there.
Fields it at the 1.
with trips to the lane. On the ground with a tailback. He tries to spin. And he's taken down. 3 yards there on the play.
It was only 2 and 7.
Second down and seven.
Dude, all that spinning. 10 minutes in, we're still in the first quarter.
South Carolina lines up with a split backfield.
I wish they had a accelerated clock on them, like Madden do.
On the ground, up the middle. He's gobbled up in the backfield. And they lose a couple there.
A couple, they only used those two.
Third and nine, ball on the 18-yard line. The Gamecocks with four receivers. Drops back to pass, steps up in the pocket, looks. He's rolling right, he's going right. Got it, he can scoot. Across midfield, at the 40, at the 30.
That's just airing it out on third down.
That was more than enough to pick up the first down. Next time, this defense will be playing on their heels.
That dude caught that. He got hit. Nope. That's it. Nope. Okay, I see y'all Gamecocks. I don't know what that means, but
it's first and 10,
I see y'all Gamecocks.
Ball on the 16-yard line. South Carolina lines up with three receivers. Makes a move.
It's like every time I try to tackle this guy.
Tackle. That's a 7 yard gain.
7 yards. You did all that for 7 yards.
Well, they're in the red zone, Lee. What do you think their chances are?
It's the good news, bad news situation. The good news is they're in the red zone.
The bad news is
they aren't very good when they get down.
Sack.
To go, and he's brought down for the sack.
They've got to do a better job up front with their pass protection.
If they don't start picking up everybody, like, then this quarterback's going to be pretty sore in the morning. That's
sure. He should just let the running back keep the ball.
The offense faces another third down as they line it up.
They're throwing it. Probably a touchdown.
The Gamecock set up in the gun.
And they're doing it.
Pass, steps up, throws
man to man covers. Told you. That was
a touchdown. Nice play call on that one to get the ball in the receiver's hand.
He had a quarterback sitting. He let the ball go get it. D.D. Emmer. He got it, took it for six.
Okay.
And he tacks on the extra point. And now we'll take a look at the Pontiac drive summary. South Carolina to kick this one off. Number 21 and number 33 back ready to return. He hits a booming kick. Number 33 fields it in the end zone.
Great passing was the key for the offense the last time they had the ball. They were able to pick apart the defense and get down the field for a touchdown.
So if I'm the coach, I'm telling my defensive lineman, get more pressure on that quarterback, please.
The Volunteers come out in the ace formation. Nice play fake. Wants to throw outside. Got it to him on the run. He's knocked out of bounds.
Way to look it in. Nice catch.
Sure was. He displayed some great hands there. Now we're looking at a first down.
First and 10. Ball on the 27-yard line. Tennessee goes with the ace set here. Long ways yet to go, but at the end of one, our score, Tennessee 14, South Carolina 7. first and 10, all on their own 27. Tennessee lines up in a double tight set. There's the play fake. Rolling out to the right side. Looking. Looks like he's going to run. They'll bring him down. The quarterback trying to make a play.
Well, he did a nice job of getting some yards there on the scramble, but he needs to learn to slide to avoid those big dents.
It's second down and 5 to go. Ball on their own 32. They line up in a double tight set. He drops back. He's looking. He rolls out to the right. Short toss. Complete. And he's taken down. 1 yard gain on the play.
1 yard gain on the play.
Third down and 4 coming up on this one. Ball on the 33-yard line. Tennessee comes out with 2 tight ends. Back to pass. Looks, fires deep down the right side.
It's dropped.
This incomplete.
You got it, man. You got it. It's okay. It's okay. It's okay. Let's see if this trigger works.
This one away. Gets it away. Wait a minute, he's gonna throw. Throws this one out to the right. The ball's incomplete. They'll turn the ball over on down.
Questionable play calling there by the coaching staff. It's way too early in the game to be going for it on fourth down. I would have punted the ball in that situation.
Three wideouts to the left side. They'll throw on first down. Walks this one out to the left. They went with a shovel pass, but couldn't execute.
Now that play never developed. They might want to think about taking that one out of the playbook for now.
It's second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 33. High formation here. On the ground with the tailback. He jukes. Tackle. A pickup of about 3. Steps up, looking, with the throw. And it's caught. He breaks free. Oh, man, did he take a hit.
You're not telling me who won.
And since we're in the red zone, let's have a look at the numbers. Brought to you by Old Spice Red Zone, when performance matters the most. South Carolina lines up with 3 receivers.
Oh, man, man.
Just right. And he's going to lose yards on this one.
Anytime a defense has their safeties coming up, making plays behind the line of scrimmage, that tells the offense has got to start throwing the ball down.
Game 6.
It's second down and 12 to go.
Game 7.
The Gamecocks come out showing 3 wide. Superb catch by the wide receiver for the score. And he hits the PAT. So under 3 minutes to go in the second quarter. And the score, South Carolina 14, Tennessee 14. South Carolina ready to kick this one off. Nice kick, plenty of distance. Number 21, end zone. He spins. Their last drive ended when they decided to try for it on fourth down and were turned away by the defense. They'll set up shop at the 18-yard line. Two tight ends. Play action. Steps up in the pocket. They can't block the defensive end, and he'll get credit for the sack.
Excellent athleticism by this young man. He just beat the man in front of him, plain and simple.
Second and long, all on their own 11. The volunteer come out in the shotgun. Nice play fake. He passes it. And he got it! He's all the way down to the 42. This kid just continues to impress us with his ability to catch the football. He's already gone over 100 yards here in the first half.
He passed his defense. Who wants to cover this guy? I bet you nobody's going to raise their hand because this receiver is embarrassing.
It's first and 10. Ball in the 42. Number 7 with 3 wide receivers. He drops back. He's looking. Rolls right.
Still caught.
Across the middle. Complete. And down he goes. And they get a few yards on that little reception.
Check it out. He ran a good route on his play. And the timing of the pass was good. And they were able to get a nice gain.
The ball. Set up in the gun. Back to pass. Looks. Rolls to the left. He's going left. Someone got a hand on it. And the linebacker makes a good defensive play.
The thing I like about this play is he made the play without getting pass interference. This is a good football player.
Third and 2 coming up here. This is the 5th play of this drive. Number 7, back in the gun. Rolls to the right, looking. He keeps it. Here he goes. And he's tackled. And they convert on 3rd down.
That wasn't only a conversion, it was a big play.
One of the things that I like about this young quarterback is his ability to make things happen. This is an obvious situation where he wanted to go downfield. Once he recognized that nothing was available, instead of panicking and throwing the ball into coverage, he calmly tucks it under, and you're right, gets a huge play.
And it's caught. And he's stopped behind the line. They get a 1-yard loss on that one.
1-yard loss on the play.
Number 7 lines up in the shotgun. Drops back to pass. He's looking. Rolling right. Across the middle. Intercepted in the end zone. How about that defensive play?
What I liked here was the way the defense reacted as soon as the ball was thrown. It allowed them to come up with
the intercept.
I didn't like the decision by the quarterback. He's a smart kid. He knows better than to throw a pass like that.
They'll take over at the 3. South Carolina will line up in a jumbo set here. Play action. Looks. He rolls left. Complete. And he shoved out of bounds. They just took what the defense gave him on that play.
And you're right. That was a good job of getting that pass completed for positive yardage.
Second and 4 coming up here. Ball on the 9-yard line.
You still get the ball back.
Gamecock, come out in the shotgun. And he's taken down. So the quarterback keeper gets maybe a yard.
1 yard gain on the play.
We get 3rd and 3 here. Ball on the 10. South Carolina comes out with an eye formation.
Give.
He jukes it. And they make the stop. your ordinary fullback. This guy can move.
You bet he can. I like this kid. He's a heck of a football player. They need to get him some more carries.
Tennessee takes a timeout. It's first and 10, ball on the 26. Number 12 with three wide receivers. Inside give. They'll bring him down. This one might be coming back, folks. Let's check out the penalty.
Hold him. On the offense.
Got an inverted face mask on the defense.
What? No. That's a bull.
South Carolina calls a timeout.
That's a bull. Hold him over there. That's a bull. Okay.
The Gamecocks come out showing three wide. They'll throw on first down. Looking, rolling out to the right side. And he's hit as he throws. Got an opening. Caught. At the point. Inside the 30. To the 20. Goodbye. Touchdown, South Carolina.
And they get the ball back. They ain't gonna be losing. I'm about to be losing 28 to 14.
And he tacks on the extra point.
Stop more pinning to people. That's kind of rude.
Folks, let's pause now as we've reached. We'll see what kind of halftime adjustments were made as we prepare to start the second half. And they'll be returning this one. Number one, fields it at the three. Time once again for this offense to come back out and start another drive. They'll get the ball here at the 21. South Carolina comes to the line, only one man in the backfield. They go with a pitch to the right. And he's going to lose yards on this one. Boy, he is one big guy down there on that defensive line.
Oh, man. Nickville is a hoss. I saw him last night at the hotel. He had two bags of food going up in his room.
Yo, it looks like he's got a big old bag hanging over his belt right now.
It's second down and a long ways to go. Ball on the 15. The Gamecocks have five receivers on this play. He drops back, steps up, he's looking. He zips it out. The senior makes the catch. What do you think of that catch, Kirk?
What a steady performer this player has been. That's now over 100 yards receiving on the day for this fine young man.
First and 10, ball on the 46. Carolina goes to the ace set here. Duke move. Tackle. 3 yards there on the play. Second and 7 coming up here. Ball on the 49-yard line. Three wideouts here. Steps up, looks, wants to throw outside, and it's incomplete. It's third down and 7 to go. Ball right around midfield. Number 12 has four receivers lined up here. A little shake and bake move, and he's taken down. He may have gotten back to the line of scrimmage. It's fourth down, and the punt team lines up. Yeah. It's a high kick, and it holds up there. Number 33 signals for a fair catch. He hauls it in at the 19. And now a slight break in the action as the offense comes out of the field for their next possession. The offensive coordinator told us that sometimes they really live and die with this young man at running back, and I think that's apparent today.
Well, he's the go-to guy for this offense. He's the guy that can go the distance for them when they need a big play, and when he's not getting it done on the ground, this offense is going to struggle like we've seen so far.
To make a long story short, they're losing this football game because their star running back has no room to run against these swarming linebackers. I'm not saying anybody expected him to be able to run on this defense, but they better find ways to get him in the open field before it's too late.
Two tight end set, back to pass. Rolling out to the left side, looking, and now he's going to improvise. He's on the run. Spin move. The 50, at the point, at the 30.
That was funny.
You know what? When that quarterback saw all that open field in front of him, he went,
oh, that was right. I didn't hear him whistle, but it was certainly a big run. It's first and 10, ball on the 28. One man backfield. Play action. He throws it.
Oh, we put it up there, but he's still far.
And it falls incomplete. He led his wide receiver too far to the outside.
Yeah, he just had to pull the string a little bit more there.
Second and 10. Ball on the 28-yard line. Ace backfield. Nice play fake. He's looking. He keeps it. He lost the ball. It scooped up. Brought down. Well, they avoided a turnover right there.
Man, oh, man. That was a close one. Good thing that kid was paying attention and fell on the football.
It's first and 10, and this is the fifth play of the current drive. The Volunteers line up with two tight ends. There's the play fake. Throws it to the outside. He came down with it. Touchdown. That pass found the wide receiver for six.
Quarterback has found a soft spot in this
defense.
That was an aggressive call, Coach, but they just could not get it into the end zone for two.
No question. You don't see too many coaches pass up the chance to tie the ball game. But he had confidence they could get it. Maybe too much confidence.
Decent kick. Looks to be returnable. Number one fields it at the two. He spins around. The offense comes back on the field, hoping to build off their last drive.
They had something going, but were unable to get any points.
They'll start this drive at the 22. The Gamecocks come out in the ace formation. A 2-yard run by the halfback. Second and 8 coming up here. Ball on 24. The Gamecocks come out showing 3 wide. Back to pass. Lets it fly. Picks it off. There he goes. Touchdown, Tennessee. What an interception by the quarterback.
I love it. A defensive back with soft hands. This kid can play.
Mm-hmm. impact linebacker has turned it up a notch. And the extra point. No, it's a fake. Number 25 is lined up to kick this one off. And he got all of this one. Great kick. Number one fields it in the end zone.
I know the first thing I wanted to do after throwing a pick was to come out that next drive and throw. Let the defense know that I wasn't a teammate.
And how many times did you go right back in there and throw another pick?
I mean, as you know, a quarterback needs a short memory, so I really don't remember, Stu.
Four wide. Drops back to pass. Steps up in the pocket. Looks. Pressure coming. They'll make the sack. The fourth-year man at defensive end brings down the quarterback for the sack.
That's exactly what you'd expect out of a senior. Big plays to fire this defense up.
Shotgun. He drops back, steps up, throws down the middle, and it's caught. Got some open field. Loose football, and they fall on the loose ball. And he is drilled. They turn the ball over to the defense with that fumble, and the head coach has got to be upset with his halfback after that one.
Any coach would be upset after his running back fumbles. The first thing a running back learns is how to grip and secure the football.
Hopefully he shakes it off and forgets about it. There's nothing he can do now.
It's first and 10. Ball of the 29. Tennessee lines up in a double tight set. Nice play fake. And they get the sack. The tackle got embarrassed that time, allowing the end to come free for the sack.
That's what you call a lookout block. The tackle gets beat and yells, "Look out!" Trust me, it's not what you want to hear as a quarterback.
Second and long coming up here. Ball on the 38-yard line.
I'm not losing this game.
And this impact linebacker is fired up down there. He rolls out to the right. He goes downtown. And they couldn't hook up on that one. He couldn't make the catch inbound.
You can't fault the receiver. He did all he could to make the catch. Pass was just too far out of play.
Here's a third and long situation. Ball on the 38. One man backfield. Trick play might not work. Throws this one out to the right. It falls
on the
right.
You gotta be careful when you're calling a trick play like this, because it's usually a huge gain or a turnover. They were lucky it was only incomplete.
Number seven comes to the line with three wide. Play action. He wants it all. Going long. And he
what a shame. What a shame. That was supposed to be a pick.
It's touchdown catch number two.
Hey, this guy's really stepped up for his football team today.
Well, it's obvious the coach wanted to get him involved in the game plan. It looks like it was a pretty smart move, too.
So here's the Pontiac drive summary to recap what just happened.
No.
Tennessee is
no,
ready to kick it away. Kicks it off. Number one, fields at the goal line. The last time they had the ball, they gave it away on the fumble.
The old ball coach was not too happy about that either. They will see that happens again.
They'll go to work at the 23-yard line. times. Come out in the ace formation. Back to pass. He's looking down the middle. Complete. And down he goes. 8 yards on the pickup. Second and two. Ball on the 31. South Carolina goes with the ace set here. He steps up. He'll dump this one off. Incomplete. Third and two coming up here. Ball on the 31-yard line. The Gamecocks line up in an I formation. Toss right side. Can he get the first? And he's taken down. The defense punches him off the field after just three plays.
That was a short round, Brad. Nothing seems to be working right now.
And the punt team will come out. It's fourth down. Number 92 punts it, and it's a good one. With the spin, number 33 fields it at the 22. The 50. Thanks to some nice passing on the last drive, the offense was able to take it down the field for six.
And great play calling to help make that an easy drive. The question is, can they do it again?
Excellent field position to start the drive. They come out with a big set. Rolls right, looking. Down the middle. Got it. And he's tackled.
Now that was a good-looking play. The quarterback put it where his receiver could get it, and now they have a first down.
What I like is the faith that this quarterback has in his receiver. He's not afraid to throw it downfield.
And we take a quick look at the stats from within the red zone, brought to you by Old Spice Red Zone, when performance matters the most. Tennessee lines up in a double tight set. On the ground with a tailback. And down he goes. They keep it on the ground, and the halfback gets about 7 yards. Let's see if they can get it in for the touchdown. He's rolling left, and they got him for a loss. The defense now has 4 sacks in the ballgame. On the 11, going in. The ball, Camacho in 3 wide. He's looking. Throws it to the outside. He brings it down. Touchdown. A great throw, and that's his second touchdown catch of the game.
The quarterback knew exactly where to put the pass, and the receiver went out there and made the grab. Good communication.
On the extra point. So with just over 4 minutes remaining in the fourth quarter, the score is Tennessee 40, South Carolina 21. Tennessee ready to kick this one off. Number 8 and number 1 back to return. He kicks it. Number 8 fields it at the 2. At the 30. Not a whole lot of success there last time out.
This offense has to do a better job of standing on the field and giving their defense a chance to catch their breath.
They'll set up shop at the 35-yard line. South Carolina in a 5-wide set. He drops back. He lost this one over the middle. And it falls incomplete. And he
overthrew his wide receiver.
I don't know too many 7-foot guys play football, so maybe he should aim lower the next time.
So it's 2nd and 10, all on their own 35. Two tight ends here. On the ground with a tailback. And he stops.
doesn't plug up holes, he plugs up the whole line down there.
Yep.
Number 12, back in the gun. Drop back to pass, throws it to the outside. And that one's fallen incomplete. He had his wide out, but he couldn't hit him.
When he misses, it's usually high. And that's something he's been working very hard with his coach on.
They come out in a five-wide set. Back to pass. Across the middle. The ball is tipped. He ignores the footsteps and makes the catch. What an unbelievable fourth down conversion.
That was a big-time play. Heck of a job there to keep this drive going.
One man backfield. They go with a toss. And they got him for a loss.
Now that's what I'd love to see. A linebacker who plays downhill against a run. That guy knows exactly what the heck is going on out there.
The Gamecock set up in the gun. And he's hit as he throws. The blitz was very effective that time.
Yep, they brought the house. It was all they could do to get the ball out of there.
Third and 13 coming up. And this is the seventh play of the current drive. Number 12 lines up with five wideouts. He drops back. He lets it go. Got it. Brought down. What do you think of this quarterback, Lee?
Well, he's got over 300 yards passing now. And what I like about him is his quick release. One, two, three.
And we take a quick look at the stats from within the red zone. Brought to you by Old Spice Red Zone. When performance matters the most. Another trip to the red zone. Last time, it resulted in a touchdown. It falls incomplete, and this one could be on the defense.
That's a clearance. On the offense.
That penalty will move him back a bit.
Yeah, and with so many young guys out there, it's bound to happen occasionally.
It's first and goal.
Ball on the 24-yard line. The Gamecocks come out the shotgun, drops back to pass, rolls to the right, and he's going to be sacked. He'll feel that one in the morning.
You bet he will. I mean, just look at that guy that sacked him. He's a monster. I could have swore I felt the earth shake when he hit the ground.
That brings up second and goal, and this is the ninth play of the current drive. They come out in a five-wide set, throws it to the outside. It's tipped. And it's incomplete. The pass was knocked down.
This defense is very aggressive, and they swarm to the football. They're always making plays to disrupt the passing.
Third down now, and goal to go. This is the 10th play of this drive. They'll work from the shotgun. Back to pass. Throws it out there. And they couldn't hook up on that one. And the wideout couldn't drag a foot.
Yeah, but he showed really nice hands on that play.
Number 12, back in the gun. He drops back, steps up in the pocket, looks. He unloads it. Got it to the senior. And they're going to have to give the ball back after going for it on fourth and long.
Not much you can do there. You got to go for it and give yourselves a chance.
It's first and 10. Ball on their own 29. The Volunteers come out in a two tight end set. On the ground with the tailback. Picked up big yards there, and he's going to have a first down.
Yeah, nice job there. This guy does a good job of reading his blocks and accelerating through the hole.
First and 10, ball on the 47. Tennessee goes with the ace set here. He gets another carry. And they make the stop, and the delayed handoff works for a big gain.
Got to be happy with the effort there by your tailback.
You are absolutely right.
It's first and 10, ball on the 37-yard line. One man backfield. They keep it on the ground with the tailback. And he's tackled. This guy just made those 10 yards look easy.
short. Ball on the 27. He's backfield. On the ground with the tailback. That didn't go anywhere.
Yeah, I'll tell you why. They would come with a heavy blitz. The guys would shoot through the line right into the backfield. That play didn't have a chance.
Looking. Go into the end zone. Hauls it in.
They have that defense guessing now or what? I mean, did you see how well the quarterback hit the ball?
Yeah, some quarterbacks are just so good at selling the play action. Truly an overlooked skill. You take my friend Kirk here, for example. He wasn't known for his speed, but boy, he could do a good play fake.
You calling me slow? This is coming from a guy whose nickname is based on his foot speed. Isn't that right, Scooter?
Yeah, left out Sunshine. It's Sunshine Scooter, sweetheart.
Here's the drive summary brought to you by Pontiac. Tennessee is ready to kick it away. Number 8 and number 1 back deep to return. Kicks it off. Number 8 fields it in the end zone. Their last drive ended when they decided to try for it on fourth down and were turned away by the defense. They'll take over at the 20. The Gamecocks have 5 receivers on this play. Throw. And down he goes. Only 3 yards there on the throw. Second and 7. Ball on the 23-yard line. The Gamecocks go with the I formation. On the ground with the tailback. They'll bring him down. South Carolina takes a timeout. It's third down and 6 to go. Ball on the 24-yard line. From the gun. Drops back to pass. Steps up. He's looking. He's under some heat. And down he goes. South Carolina calls a timeout. And now they've only got 1 remaining. Coming up here. Ball on the 40-yard line. They better block that linebacker. He is looking to make something happen. And he's hit hard. Kirk, how many sacks do they have now?
That gives them 5 for the game. This offensive line has got to do a better job of protecting their quarterback.
Third down and a couple miles here. Ball on the 48-yard line. Nickel defense. There's a play fake. Long ball, right side. And got him! And he's brought down. That was a beautiful pass play.
And you can see why they like running this play. They have the potential to break one every single time they run.
The Volunteers line up with 2 tight ends. Here comes the pressure. Touchdown, Tennessee! And thank goodness this one finally comes to an end, because I'd hate to see it get any uglier. Coach, what's your final thought on the game?
I can't say enough about this performance. Tennessee played an excellent game out there.
We look forward to calling more games of NCAA football 2006. But until then, our final score in this one, Tennessee 53, South Carolina 21.
That was a good game right there.